Welcome to this session. This is the discussion about the reactions that are responsible for the damage of the carbon blocks inside the hearth of the blast furnace. With the use of different varieties of improved carbon blocks like micropore carbon blocks, super micropore carbon blocks, and with regular gunniting or short treating of the upper part of the furnace, instead of using different varieties of high alumina bricks, mulite, corundum, etc. in the hearth, the campaign life of the blast furnace has been increased to 20 to 30 years instead of 5 to 10 years based on the studies over the postmortem analysis of carbon blocks after different campaigns of blast furnace. A wear-out mechanism has been developed. First, a lost out portion or worn out portion is seen, that means which is lost already in the hearth during operation. This is due to the chemical corrosion and mechanical erosion. When metal comes in contact with the carbon blocks, that metal which is not yet saturated gets its carbon by dissolution from the surface of the blocks for its saturation, and that metal always changing the surface because there is flow, continuous flow of metal slag and other particles inside the hearth. So fresh metal will come and again it will take carbon for dissolution from the surface of the block, and by this way there will be chemical corrosion of the block and block will be eaten away. Similarly, because of the flow inside the hearth of metal, slag, coke, etc., there will be mechanical impact over the surface of the hearth and there will be erosion. Now, this justifies why a freeze line of or scuff formation is necessary at the surface of the carbon block. What is a scuff or freeze line? It is nothing but a solidified layer of slag and coke. When there is tapping, metal comes down, this slag floating above it always rolls down over the surface of the block and it is cooled gradually and solidified over the surface of the block. As the carbon block has very high thermal conductivity, so the surface will be cooled, so it will be easily solidified. Now, this process will go on, solidification of slag coke particles over the surface with time if productivity is at the optimum level. That means there is chance of formation of a scuff or freeze line, because it is always some part is getting melted and coming into the hearth and some part is remaining there. So there should be an optimum so that scuff formation is there, and that scuff has very low thermal conductivity and this acts as a insulation layer. So what happens when there is a thick layer of scuff or freeze line? The metal temperature that is not touching the carbon block face hot surface, so there will be less temperature than the metal, so the reactions at the surface, the reaction rate at the surface will be less. Now the other type of damage is the metal penetration and crack formation in the block. Now under common ferrostatic head, metal can penetrate when the pore diameter is greater than 10 millimicron. So when the pore diameter is greater than 10 millimicron, metal will enter the pore. Now let us imagine a situation. The hot phase temperature is 50 degree centigrade, cold phase temperature 50 degree centigrade, and the block length is 1400 millimeter. So there is a temperature drop of 1450 minus 50, that is 1400 degrees centigrade along the length of 1400 millimeter of the carbon block. So that means that there will be a drop in temperature for each millimeter. So at a distance of 300 millimeter, there will be a point that is at a temperature of 300 means 300 degrees centigrade. So 1450 minus 300, that is 1150 degrees centigrade. So that point, the temperature is 1150 degrees centigrade. So any plane in the block vertical at that point, that all this point have the temperature of 1150 degrees centigrade. This is called the 1150 degrees centigrade isotherm. That means the same temperature. When metal is penetrating, that is flowing inside, and during its flow inside, it is taking carbon from the pore wall for its saturation. In this way, that is getting damaged, and this metal will penetrate up to the point of 1150 degrees centigrade, because 1150 degrees centigrade is the saturation point of the metal. At that point, when metal is getting solidified, during this solidification, there will be huge volume contraction by 8%. So again there will be void, and metal will again penetrate. By this penetration, solidification and volume contraction, there will be a development of huge stress, and that will be the center of crack propagation. Now, on the other hand, when with time the surface of the block is getting eroded, the 1150 degree centigrade isotherm will not be at that point, that will also be shifted, because some of the part is already gone inside the hearth. So 1150 degree centigrade isotherm will be shifted, and again metal will penetrate. In this way, with time, metal penetration will be continued. Now we see another type of damage in the used carbon blocks, that is the formation of a brittle layer along the 800 degree centigrade isotherm. This is explained as, when potassium and zinc vapor is entering into the open pores of the carbon blocks, it is going inside. At 800 degree centigrade isotherm, this potassium and zinc, which is converted to potassium oxide and zinc oxide during its travel by oxidation with carbon dioxide, it is getting condensed. That means potassium and zinc vapor is converted into potassium oxide and zinc oxide by oxidation with carbon dioxide inside the pore, and that is flowing inside, and at 800 degree centigrade isotherm, that is being condensed. This condensate or liquid, that is falling over the micropore wall. Now, in that portion, this hot liquid is reacting with the inorganic ashes present in the carbon block. This inorganic ashes is having your aluminum oxide, L2O3, and SiO2, iron oxide. So potassium oxide and zinc chloride is forming potassium aluminate, potassium silicate, zinc aluminate, zinc silicate, and calophyllite K2O, L2O3, twice SiO2, leucite K2O, twice L2O3, 4 SiO2. All these compounds at that temperature are liquid, and this formation of this liquid is occurring with a very high volume expansion, such that due to this volume expansion, inside this micropore, that pore's wall is getting damaged, and the stress is so much that the block is getting crumbled. We see another type of damage in between 800 degree centigrade isotherm and 500 degree centigrade isotherm. Actually, this portion is slightly damaged. This is due to the reaction by oxygen, water or steam, and carbon monoxide. When oxygen is entering inside the pore of the block, it is adsorbed by the micropore wall and it is reacting at that time with carbon of the block, and it is converted to carbon monoxide. And in this way, this carbon monoxide which is formed, that is dissolved from the micropore wall, and block is getting corroded. Similarly, when there is leakage in the tuyere, or when water is coming from the leakage of the cooling element, that water above 100 degree centigrade, that is getting converted into steam. That steam is reacting with carbon of the block at a temperature above 500 degree centigrade, forming CO and hydrogen gas, that is water gas reaction. Now, steam can react with carbon above 450 degree centigrade, but the reaction of carbon with steam in between 400 degree to 500 degree centigrade, 450 degree centigrade to 500 degree centigrade, is very less or not appreciable at all. So we should take care so that steam cannot come in contact with the carbon block at a temperature above 500. When carbon monoxide is entering inside the open pore of the carbon blocks, it is reacting with the iron oxide present in the inorganic ashes. What is the inorganic ash? Inorganic ashes is the inorganic compounds present in the carbon block itself. In the analysis, it has been seen that it varies from 7 to 22% in different types of carbon blocks. And generally, graphite blocks is having the least inorganic compounds. When carbon monoxide is reducing the iron oxide to elemental iron, then the elemental iron in its nascent state is very much reactive and adsorbing carbon monoxide gases present there, forming FeCO complex. This FeCO complex is disintegrated to different carbides of iron, CO2, oxygen, and deposition of carbon particles inside the pore. This deposition generates stress inside the micropore and the microstructure is damaged. So carbon block will be damaged. The portion which is in between the 500 degree centigrade isotherm to the rest part of the block is having almost no reaction. Practically no reaction takes place in this part from the shell side part to 500 degree centigrade isotherm. The chemical compositions of the block remains almost same as with the original carbon block. Now, from this discussion, now it is evident why we are using carbon blocks in the hearth of the blast furnace for prolonging the life of the blast furnace. Because carbon block can withstand a very high temperature, it is inert to different substances, and carbon block has very high thermal conductivity. This helps in the formation of scuff or fridge line on the surface of the blocks, so that metal or slag cannot come directly in contact with the hot face. So there is less chance of any reaction on the hot face, and that will prolong the carbon block life. And we are using micropore or super micropore carbon blocks because their pore size is such less than 5 millimicron, and metal cannot penetrate inside the block, and so metal penetration will not be there and life of the carbon block will be more. And other thing is, we are using less permeable carbon block so that the harmful gases cannot penetrate inside the pore. Now, the supermicropore carbon block is having very less permeability. Permeability is less than 1 millidarcy C with nitrogen. So these harmful gases cannot penetrate inside the pore and these reactions are prevented. Otherwise, if these reactions are allowed, then with time there will be metal penetration, there will be crumble layer, and all these are forming only discontinuity in the block. This discontinuity resists the smooth flow of the heat from the hot phase to the cold phase or to the cooling element. So the heat flow will be resisted and the temperature at the hot phase will be increased. At the hot phase temperature will go on increasing, the 1150 degree centigrade isotherm will be shifted towards the colder side. And again there will be mental penetration and this phenomena will go on continuously with time and the block will be damaged gradually and the half-life will be decreased. So to prolong the half-life, to get the highest Campbell life of the blast furnace, these precautions are to be taken. Thank you.